Today we will talk about the communication between servers. Let's begin. The data exchange between two or more servers is known as server-to-server communication. Many applications, such as web hosting, email, and file sharing, require this type of communication. Server-to-server communication can be accomplished through a variety of mechanisms, including HTTP, TCP, IP, and SMTP. Requests use HTTP and HTTPS protocols and can be used to connect applications, and response standards for communication include HTML, XML, JSON, RSS, and others. In addition, there are numerous request standards, including REST API and GraphQL. REST API. The most popular form of communication between servers is REST API. REST API has standards in type, format, and name of URL. Request types can be post, put, get, delete, etc. REST API can provide different types. Sometimes, it responds with other formats. For example, api/comments.json gives SUN when api/comments.xml gives XML. It's often based on back-end database structure. The structure is shared between all connected applications. GraphQL. GraphQL is a language that provides dynamic data depending on the request. That means the server that requests data can ask for any available combination of data they want. However, all need to be defended, and side requests need to know GraphQL standards. GraphQL responds to JSON format. An example of GraphQL. For more information, check the official website, https://graphql.org. It is also possible to send data to the same server by SMTP, is the standard channel for sending emails. Like Redis, queue by sending and receiving messages on the same server. We have an apparent sender here, but it is necessary to verify that the message is valid for the specific receiver. By database, however, database is the worst way to communicate because it creates chaos. Nobody knows what was written by which application, and setting up privileges within a single database can be difficult. In addition, later problems can be confusing. By issuing commands, an application can share information on the same server. The command can receive arguments and parameters and provide a variety of information. However, that information requires parsing and must be on the same server or local network. What do we need to send between applications? It depends, but you could ask yourself the following questions. What is the bare minimum of data that must be sent? How modular and adaptable should this data be? Who should have access to this information? Consider how many different external and internal receivers may require this data if you are the sender. Documentation is also required for external API. That's API that provides data by another service or to another services. In conclusion, communication between servers is critical for a smooth running website and applications. Developers can communicate more effectively with one another and troubleshoot issues more quickly if they use the right tools. Furthermore, understanding the various ways we can communicate with our servers allows us to optimize our applications and ensure a positive user experience. Did you know all of these communication methods? Let us know in the comments below. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this. Thank you for watching and see you in the next one.